breath, deep breath, deep breath. Take a few to pop and toss the sky. Take a deep breath, deep breath, deep breath, deep breath. Well, Angus, two absolute wars in the first two matches. And this is a very interesting look the anime prince is sporting. Very familiar, if you ask me.
Yeah, I mean, he's ripping off someone who might not like being ripped off, but of course we haven't seen him in OCW for years, so as typical of the target's Bray picks, he might be safe from their retribution.
A very nice look indeed, the mad anime prince coming out here now, looking to take down the man who has been just at his throat for the last month or so, the last blacksmith.
Yeah, and for good reason.
I gotta tell you, Angus, this is a hybrid I thought I would never feast my eyes on.
Yeah, well, Bray's a fan of Dragon Ball Z, and that certainly has fusion, so perhaps he's hoping for a slice of Mad Michael Morrison's power as he takes on the indomitable blacksmith, who's almost turned into a fan favorite just through his perseverance in the past few weeks.
Good luck.
Of course, it's hard not to be a fan favorite when you're fighting Bray.
Good luck getting Mad Mike to put on the Patara earrings. Oh, what is this? Welcome to Certified Greatness 2019. We've seen greatness, we've seen blood feuds only this early in the pay-per-view, and that was certified terrifying.
What a creepy new intro on the part of the last blacksmith. As I talk about him possibly, you know, having the fans on his side, he comes out with laughter and blood dripping.
And I can't disagree with you, the fans have really stood behind blacksmith. The OCW universe really enjoying the story of perseverance from the Italian last blacksmith. Now he's
the
got
Italian,
the biggest challenge.
Stallion mask.
Yeah, the Italian stallion in a lot of ways. Facing his biggest challenge to date in the anime prince. And I failed to mention, but I'm sure you'll find out soon, this match, under extreme rules, anything goes, no disqualification, that's just the way these two men like it. We are underway.
And Blacksmith, as you can see, taped up after those nasty chair shots from Bray. It may not be at 100% for this match.
Oh my god, and now he's certainly not, as he exclamation points himself headfirst into the mat.
And certainly another quick start.
Very fast-paced action.
Plant him.
Big-time DDT from the anime prince, and he's going right to the weapons.
Of course he is. I mean, he's a coward. Let's not mince words about it.
Oh my god, another brutal missed high-octane maneuver from the last blacksmith. That's one way to tear your quad.
Yeah, not going too well for him so far, but again, we're talking about the perseverance.
Ooh!
A big cutter on the chair.
The mad anime prince catching his neck on the chair there. Blacksmith looking to follow up. Shot to those injured ribs now. And the anime prince holds all the cards, got him up in the powerbomb position. The chair, my God! What a brutal powerbomb just minutes into this battle.
Wasting no time. Ray's making sure he has everything stacked on his side, and a missed dive from him too.
Neither of these men can really connect with anything that they're going for. The missed Meteora followed up by the missed Enziguri, and now Blacksmith finally found his target. Well, maybe not. Russian leg sweep taken down. Oh, and a little theatrics after the Russian leg sweep. He looked to be technical, but leave it to the anime prince Bray to always put his own flair on everything he does.
Of course, because he's so egotistical. He has to make sure the universe knows he's the best, even if he's only the best, with the help of Otakuro.
Oh,
and Kane shot.
Singapore Kane to the chest, and the table he pulled out fell right on top of him.
Give him that gladiatorial thumbs down, telling him that it's over, or it will be. Remember, Blacksmith gets what he's looking for.
The last Blacksmith has made it very clear that he takes his loss to Drago at the Clash to heart. And that's one of the reasons the crowd seems to love him so much coming into this. Bow with Bray finally connects on a suicide dive that maybe hurt him more than it did the anime prince.
Yeah, put the suicide in the dive right into the table, knocked him over with the force. But, I mean, it's not going to feel good going shoulder first into a wooden table.
I'll tell you what, there are some times where these hardcore matches don't live up to the hardcore aspect of it, but this is not one of them. Both of these guys know how to use these weapons, and they're planning on doing it even more. It's very early in the match still.
Yeah, no, or what, 5 minutes in, he's already been thrown face first into a ladder. It's only going to get worse from here for both men. It's going to be a story of perseverance through the violence.
High pace, fast action, and the last Blacksmith not going to slow that down anytime soon. He's going to the high rent district with his opponent in a suplex. We're going vertical, Angus. Superplex. Down goes the anime prince.
Almost landed his foot right on that ladder. Narrowly missed it. That could have been really bad.
And the anime prince, he is one that loves cosplay, and he is pulling it off right now. The mad Michael Morrison tribute. Oh, and a big golden opportunity, Black Phoenix type maneuver, pointing to himself there. The mad anime prince trying to regain control after the slow start.
Yeah, anime prince is certainly someone who needs his attitude adjusted.
Nice. Blacksmith alone in the ring, and I think I hear Bray outside setting up a table. Blacksmith wants
He's
none of it coming out in front of
weapon.
Us.
Making sure the fight is equal, and Bray came without a weapon, and that may have been a mistake.
And it certainly was, as Blacksmith catches him in the midsection, trying to injure the ribs himself. But once again, Bray catching him. Another theatrical Russian leg sweep.
I'm sure he'd call it the Japanese leg sweep if he could hear us right now.
God, so brilliant. What a call. Pile driver. Oh my God, that's on the chair! Bray using the chair as a dangerous weapon. That's going to keep him down. No, Blacksmith, no mere mortal. Still kicking out at one somehow.
Yo, this is one of those matches where kickouts might not just be a matter of can you, it's should you. I mean, that kind of stuff could give you a concussion. You don't want to be wrestling with a concussion, but it doesn't look like either man's going to be backing down.
I don't think it's going to take more than a concussion to keep the Blacksmith and the anime prince away from one another. These two have been at each other's throat for a long time, and we have seen some rookie dominance. We're only three matches in, and we crowned a new light heavyweight champion. We've seen one rookie take down the beast known as Drago Caesar. Bray, no slouch of his own. We'll see if he can conquer the rookie he's in the ring with right now. Here's the cover. Not looking good for him. Just a one count.
Yeah, the new blood is rising in OCW, and it's rising fast.
And I think the blood,
that table.
I think the blood pressure of the anime prince is rising fast now, too, as the Blacksmith lighting that table on fire.
Bray, that ladder defensively in front of him, doesn't want to get anywhere near that table.
Oh, and he didn't even have a choice, taking a shot to the face of that ladder. And now trying to catch his breath as he retreats into the corner. Several chops now. Oh my God.
Leg first in the ladder, but Bray's still up, managing to counter that enziguri.
Bray tried to go downstairs. Nothing home.
Superior size.
And now it's a battle of the back and forth, Zangus.
Once again, the strength advantage there, managing to push him off.
Tried to catch him with the running clothesline. There's a head scissor takeover. We saw plenty of those in the H2O Cassidy Hayes match, and Blacksmith using him to his own advantage. And now bad intention from Blacksmith. The ball, the anime prince, shoulder first into the ring post. This match, again, no disqualification, a couple of feet to the chest, and now Blacksmith in full control.
Big advantage going for that pin. Only a one count.
And you can see Blacksmith exhausted after that flurry of offensive maneuvers on the anime prince.
Yeah, we see he's got the run of the ring now. We'll see what he decides to do with the array of lethal weapons set before him. A ladder, a chair, a flaming table, and he wants to add even more to the mix. The table's still burning.
That's some flammable wood out there, and the Singapore cane being used against the blacksmith. Ah, one of his favorite weapons, and now Bray using it to torture his opponent.
Yes, of course, it's your favorite things, the things you love most, that hurt you the most when times get bad.
The first suspect in any murder is the one we love, and now it seems to be that way for the last blacksmith as he crawls back to his feet, certainly to only endure mere punishment.
Bray not letting up on the offensive, trying to keep it on him. Doesn't want him to get that advantage again.
And we saw this earlier in the night, sunset flip! This is dangerous for both competitors. Ted, down, count him! No, just not even a one count.
Not a championship winning roll up this time.
The last blacksmith did not watch the drop kick. Blacksmith, he may be a savvy rookie. He may be a strong rookie, but he's still a rookie.
And of course, as we proved early in the night, we may prove later in the night, rookies can accomplish amazing things in OCW. He just keeps the pressure on. Keeps Bray on the ropes, just like right now.
Now what does he have in mind? Blacksmith picking Bray up over his head. Oh my god, that table's outside! Oh my god! The scoop slam, Bray! Blacksmith showing the power of his own! What is going on?
He's like two-thirds the size of Bray. He just picked him up over his head and threw him out there. Threw him like a sack of garbage into a flaming table.
The Italian last blacksmith channeling the power of KD, throwing him over the top rope in the Rumble Grounds. Channeling all of that fire to throw him through the flaming table.
Super mushroom.
Oh my god. I wish I had a sound effect. And somehow the anime prince shakes the ash and the char off to get back in the ring and strike down the blacksmith with the cane.
And just that quickly, momentum is back in the anime prince's favor. Throwing him in a chair in the corner, head first.
Unbelievable. It's been a bloodbath. An absolute bloodbath, Angus. And I know
the ladder as well.
Oh, these two men hate each other more than anything else. And it's shown. It's really shown. They've really put everything they've had into proving that they are the better man. But one thing that's not talked about as we go vertical with the last blacksmith, this may be a sort of passing of the torch. One of these two men may jump up and potentially face the winner of the CCW championship match later tonight in their near future.
Yeah, certainly the terminal rankings have been shaken up. And of course, Scum Society still continuing that dominance. Jacob Trance waiting for the opportunity to do to Rex what Rex did to him many times.
The battle continues here, and it feels like a marathon. Oh my god, no! Taste of Darkness! The horse kick! And the anime prince! He didn't see it coming! I didn't see it coming! I had more comments, but we've got a horse kick! One! Two! That's gonna do it! Three! The blacksmith is your winner!
I really thought Bray had him there, but just like that, one, two, three.
And the last blacksmith picking up his second ever pay-per-view win!
Oh, he can't say he didn't deserve it. That was a war.
And we have more wars on deck for you. An incredible battle thus far. Stay tuned, Baltimore!